to New Zealand's Breakfast.
Yes, it is brilliant that you could join us this Wednesday morning. Here's what we've got coming up for you this morning. Great show. Are these designs, let's have a look at them, are they fit for Auckland's Party Central? We examine the plans for Queen's Wharf. Remember, not just Auckland, this is the gateway to New Zealand. Will it be the outstanding centrepiece for the city we had hoped for?
And cranking up the protest action against the government's handling of the smacking referendum, we talked to one man putting a lot of money where his mouth is.
Yes, we'll refire that old horny chestnut, won't we? Growing old with the young. We look at the changing role of grandparents in helping raise today's children. More and more of them are doing it.
And we need them. And before 8, what you need to know if you're thinking of hiring a batch this summer holiday. First up, though, here is Peter with the news.
Good morning. A man is in custody this morning following a series of sex attacks in the South Auckland suburb of Mangere. The man was taken away by police after approaching a young girl in a walkway where there have been 3 sex attacks in the past month and a half. The spate of attacks is worrying locals.
I have to walk through here, like, every day, so there's not that much protection for me. If I got a little daughter, I wouldn't want her to walk these streets.
Police are holding a press conference later this morning to release more information about the man they are holding. The controversial new ACC legislation has passed its first reading in Parliament. The bill to raise ACC levies and reduce entitlements went through to select committee, or to the select committee stage, by 69 votes to 53. But there was a range of speeches criticising the bill, with criticism from Labor, the Greens and Progressive MP Jim Anderton. Parliament's Transport and Industrial Relations committees will now review the bill. A Japanese Navy ship has collided with a container ship off the coast of southern Japan. The collision started fires on both ships, injuring 3 crew members. The fire on the 7,500-ton container ship was extinguished shortly after the collision, but the fire on the destroyer is still burning. Japan's defense minister has apologized for the accident and says a task force has been set up to investigate the cause of the collision. The Victoria bushfire season begins today amid warnings the state faces worse conditions than during the February firestorms, which killed 173 people. This comes as new video footage of the disaster shows some members of the public weren't paying attention. At this house in Bendigo, firefighters dashed through the flames to alert a homeowner who was watching TV.
Yeah. You've got flames almost at your back fence.
Oh, no. I can see it through there. Oh, yeah.
It's right there.
The official inquiry into the devastating bushfires has heard that following Black Saturday, Victoria Police have been retrained in basic command and coordination procedures. Tensions are building in Jerusalem as Israeli forces continue demolishing illegally constructed homes. Local Palestinians in the eastern part of the city clashed with police before bulldozers moved in to demolish their homes. Palestinians claim the local council is making it difficult and too expensive to obtain the necessary permits to build houses. In sport, the Tokyo Bledisloe Cup marketing campaign is now in full swing, with both the All Blacks and the Wallabies holding a special joint press conference in the Japanese capital. Both captains and rival players posed with the trophy for hordes of cameras, with the Japanese journalist taking a particular interest in the haka.
I guess it's just a symbol of what it means to be a New Zealander. That's the way we look at it, and it's something that I guess we enjoy doing before a game. And it's something I guess is quite unique to sport, so we're lucky to be able to do it.
After slow early ticket sales, more than 50,000 people are expected at Saturday's match in Tokyo's National Olympic Stadium. And the career of veteran Australian rugby loose forward George Smith continues to slide. Smith, who started the year as the Wallabies captain, has been dropped to the bench for Saturday's test against the All Blacks. He's been replaced by number 8 Wycliffe Palu. The other changes from the side well beaten by the All Blacks in Wellington last month are the wingers Digby Ioane and Peter Hines. The All Blacks name their team this afternoon. Well, women come in all shapes and sizes, except, of course, in magazines and on the catwalk. But across the Tasman, they're taking steps to change that viewpoint. The Australian government's unveiled a national strategy that advocates showing women's bodies as they really are. This from Dana Robertson of Australia's ABC.
Maybe on the screen. Even the professionally beautiful can struggle to live up to magazine perfection.
I agreed to it being this big, but now that it's this big, look at my spots.
As a member of the government's body image advisory group, Sarah Murdoch is using her own face to expose digital trickery, posing for a cover shot that hasn't been altered.
There, wrinkles and all.
The advisory group wants the media, fashion and advertising industries to sign a voluntary code of conduct, which would force disclosure of digital enhancement. They also want models to be at least 16 and of a clearly healthy weight, and for different shapes, sizes and ethnicities to be portrayed. In short, more of this and much less of this.
There are millions of Australians who are not aware that virtually every single image they see published in magazines has been digitally altered, often drastically.
They say it'd be a win-win for both business and consumers.
The campaigns that we've seen to date that show diversity in body shapes and sizes, actually they're being the most successful.
The government's also being asked to explore ways to standardise clothing sizes.
Negative body image is not just some teenage passing fad. It's something to take seriously.
But no answer will fit everybody.
Now to the top stories on tvnz.co.nz this morning. A 9-year-old Lower Hutt schoolboy finds what's believed to be an old human skeleton at a Wairarapa beach. Formula One's Bernie Eccleston offers Silverstone the chance to keep the British Grand Prix. And former Oasis frontman Liam Gallagher says he's going to start a new band in the new year. I didn't know he had any friends left. That is news and sport for now. More for you at 7. Here are Paul and Pippa.
Bernie Eccleston's birthday today.
Really?
Here's the thing.
Has he got any taller?
Interesting thing. I just don't think you do once you get to a certain age, Peter. Mm. I just don't think taller is something that you can look forward to.
Maybe wider.
It? He's just got a tall girlfriend.
He's got a very nice girlfriend, hasn't he?
She's but I think way up there.
Formula One, I think Formula One attracts that kind of lady, doesn't it? Mm. Doesn't it? If you look at lots of the ladies that hang around Formula One,
maybe
they're tall and
slim. Just because he has a lovely personality.
Yeah, it's well, she was only interested in his personality. Likewise, that's all he was interested in. All right, let's go to the weather now. We're going to Gore.
We're going to Gore, that's right. Welcome everybody to day two of the Great Coffee Road Trip. Gore is where we've rocked up to today. And I tell you, the weather is supposed to get a little bit sour around here today. I'm talking about cold southerlies. There's supposed to be some snow up on the hills as well, which is why I'm dressed appropriately. I'm ready to take on anything this morning. Well, kinda. Let's find out what's happening in your neck of the woods, though. Let's go to the maps and see what's happening up in the sky. First of all, down around these parts...